I want to invite your attention, please. You all forgive me. This time of year, I'm not sure when it's gonna shake, but the older you get, the longer it stays. Is that right? I want to invite your attention this morning to the New Testament, Hebrews chapter 12, starting in verse number 1. You shall have found it, say amen, and stand to your feet to honor the reading of this portion of God's word. Hebrews chapter number 12. Starting verse number 1, I'm reading from the New Revised Standard Version of the Bible. You'll find these words. Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and the sin that clings so closely. Let us run with perseverance the race that is set before us. How do we run? Look into Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith, who for the sake of the joy that was set before him, endured the cross, disregarding its shame, and has taken his seat at the right hand of God. Consider him who endured so much hostility against himself from sinners, so that we may not grow weary or lose heart. Who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, disregarding its shame, and has taken his seat at the right hand of the throne of God. I want to preach for about 10 minutes, I promise, from the subject, finding the power to stay on your cross. Finding the power to stay on your cross. Let's go to God in prayer. Father, where I am, you brought me. What I know, you taught me. What I have, you gave me. What I am, Lord, you made me. Lord, I'm depending on you. Can't do nothing till you come. This is your servant's prayer. I ask it in Jesus' name. And all God's children said, amen. Turn and tell somebody, neighbor, we have to find the power to stay on our cross. Turn and tell somebody else, neighbor. He never said it would be easy, but I gotta find power to stick to it until it's over. Come on and give God a praise in this place. Finding the power to stay on your cross. Y'all don't get this, but me and Reverend had a conversation. I want to talk to somebody here who's over the age of 50. Because if you are a millennial, you probably don't know what I'm going to talk about. You grew up in a time where you had CDs and MP3, is that MP? Players and iPods. side A and side B. If you wanted continuous music, you couldn't push a button and have it loop back and forth. You had to stack those bad boys up and move that hand over it. Y'all not here. And hold it up until it was time to drop. I want to talk to y'all. You all know what it's like to love a song on side A, but never turn to side B. Are y'all here? I'm talking about 45s now. Y'all know how to where you could really see yourself dancing like the Soul Train dancers. I'm talking old now. On side one, but the song on the back side, you rarely ever heard. But every now and then when something happened, you flipped it over and realized all that you had been missing. You realize that the song on side A, while it did something for you at that moment, when you really listened to side B, it took you somewhere you didn't think it would. Do I have a witness here? Sometimes you have to turn things over. Brother Ricardo said you had to flip the tortilla. Are y'all here? In order to understand some things, I want to suggest, beloved, that when it comes to our image and understanding of the cross, we need to go to side B. You know the cross, right behind me, right in front of me. You know the cross, don't you? Is the brand identity of the Christian church. Wherever you go, whether you are in America or Latin America or Europe or the Middle East, and you find a place where church folk gather, somewhere in that place, you'll find a cross somewhere. Am I right about it? When archaeologists dig and find a ruin, they can understand what it was if they find a piece or something that had a cross on it. The cross is the central identity of the Christian church. Can I talk theological for a while, Pastor McDuffie? Without the cross, there is no Christology. There is no pneumatology. There is no ecclesiology. Without the cross, all we preachers are doing is talking gibberish in a world full already of unnecessary chatter. Without the cross, our message has no power. Without the cross, the church is nothing but a gathering place no different than a fraternity or a sorority. Without the cross, there's no reason to give you all. No reason to invest your time. No reason to sacrifice your everything. For the cross reminds us that somewhere outside the city of Jerusalem, on a place called Golgotha, the son of a carpenter, trained in carpentry himself, was executed by the state for crimes of grace. He dared to preach a message that God's love had jumped outside the box of religion and tradition. Based upon that, they had to kill him, because the most dangerous thing in the world is somebody who dares to speak that God loves everybody just like he loves you. I wish I had a witness in the house today. We understand the cross is about living. He loved me. Die understand it, we get it, that the cross of Christ has made a difference in our life. That's why every now and then somebody comes to church and has to yell out, thank you. It's not because the car they just got, but it's because when I think about the goodness of Jesus and all he's done for me. We understand that Jesus paid it all. I wish I had somebody who felt like having old church today. Somebody who understood that you can have church all by yourself. When you just think about who he's coming for. I wish you had somebody here who don't mind telling somebody every now and then I have to tell them, Jesus, I never forget what you've done for me. I wish I had. We understand all about that. Christ gave us all. Christ poured it out. Christ laid it down. Christ stayed right there. Come on, Paul. A legion of angels. But he stayed right there. I heard somebody say, it wasn't the next. But that's side A. When you flip the record, deep your breath. Side B is still about the cross. But it's not about the cross that he bore. But the cross you got to carry. On side A, but when side B shows up, that's when it gets real difficult. Give me a little more here, I don't want to have much voice. When side B shows up, we get real concerned, because we don't understand that the cross is not just about the way Christ died, but it's also have to live. We have to understand that cross bearer is not just what Jesus and the apostles did, but cross bearer is what you and I got to do as well. Oh, we sing the song, don't we? The song of that prayer. Must Jesus bear the cross? From Christian identity. And I want to suggest that too many of us have gotten messed up because we are listening to folk who never turn to side B. What shows up. We get real fun. Our hands don't go up no more. Our hallelujahs are quiet. We sit on our praise like we sit on our money. We start asking God questions that God will not answer. We start going crazy, trying to lose our minds, because we brought into a modern understanding of the Christian religion that gives you all the glory but no pain. Talk to the wall, boy. We have brought into a Christian religion that tells you all you got to do is come to the Lord and everything gonna be all right. But grandmama knew a religion that when I came to the cross, I had to go through some stuff myself. Reverend, we have raised a generation of praise and worshipers that don't know how to tarry until the Lord works in. We have raised folk that want to have church, but want to have church as long as everything is going their way. But do I have a witness here? We need to learn that every now and then you've got to wear your cross. You've got to go through some stuff. And the real message is, what do you do when you're on your cross? Because the easy thing to do when you are up on your cross, the easiest thing to do is to come off. Because being on your cross is a mindset. It's how you think about stuff, Pastor. All you got to do is get into your feelings and start looking at what you're going through as something the devil has done to you and has no understanding of the purpose. It's not how big is your Bible, not how much Bible you can quote, not how long your dress is, not how dark your makeup may be, but the real testimony of a Christian is, how do you hang in there with the world looking at you upside your head? How do you find power to stay on your cross? That's what the writer of Hebrews is talking about. I got to stop now. We don't know who wrote Hebrews, but this is a book that is dipped in Jewish understanding of what God has done. Probably somebody who wrote this book was someone who was a Christian, of course, but had a strong Jewish background. And they understood the nature of sacrifice and the progressive nature of God. They understood that God spoke yesterday in one way, but God speaks today in a whole different way. They understood the purpose of sacrifice and worship as a shadowing of what was to come in Christ. They understood that as a Christian, there is a sense that you got to understand the history of where you come from. And when you get to chapter number 11, the writer of Hebrews understand it's a marathon. Reverend Duffy, I'm sorry to bother you all the time, but haven't you met Christians who come to the church and they think it's a sprint and they run up in here and as soon as things get tough, they stop running? Because the Christian journey is a marathon. That's why you gotta be careful that you don't run so quick that you forget you got a long way to go still. We are so caught up in folk that show up to church and they just run. Says, if you want to be encouraged, when you are on your cross, to find the power to stay on your cross, look to Jesus. Look at how he did. Don't miss that. Side A is his cross. Side B is our cross. But when side B is our reality, we can turn back to side A and find strength to make it one more day. Have you ever found strength in the story of our Lord? He said that when you look to him, understand that you're not the only one that had to bear a cross. You are the only one that the world stretch wide. Look to Jesus. Sometimes the problem with Christian folk is we're looking to everybody but Jesus. We're looking at our neighbor. We're looking at our friends. We're looking at our past. We're looking down. We're looking at everybody but the one we should look to. Look unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith, the King James says. And it tells you, when you look to him, what you got to do if you're going to stay on the cross. He said, when you look to Jesus, you'll find out when he was on his cross that Friday, he looked beyond the cross to the joy that was coming. Y'all miss that? Who for the joy set before him? I wish I had somebody who knew what I'm talking about. Have you ever had to go through some stuff and the only thing that kept you going was the joy that was on the way? I wish I had somebody here that knew what I was talking about. Is there anybody here that working on a job and you almost packed your bags and walked out the door, but the only thing that kept you at the cubicle was payday, was Friday, and you were going to stay right there because I don't have no voice. Look to him. When he was on his cross, he looked beyond the cross and saw joy. I want to tell somebody, I've lived long enough to know being on your cross is not easy. It doesn't feel good. But if you stay on the cross, joy will show up. I wish I had somebody do what I was talking about. You may have to cry, but joy will show up. It may not come when you want, but on your bed at 2 a.m, joy will wake you up and cause you to tell God, I thank you. Joy will show up. How do you stay on your cross? Look to Jesus and understand that he found joy in the stuff he was going through. James says, count it all joy. ago, many, many, many years ago, before some of y'all were even born, Brother Anthony, when I was in the U.S. Air Force, 19 1983, I found myself in the country of Turkey at the Incirlik Air Base in the city of Adana. I had the privilege of being a postal deliverer, and my job was to drive down from the post each morning in a U.S. military jeep or van and pick up the mail from the airport in Adana. I had to go to a meeting one day with the officials at the Turkish Airways, and I parked the vehicle and I sat there and watched an amazing thing. I saw this man delivering a refrigerator to the top floor of an apartment complex. And what got me was, this man was an elderly man, and this man didn't have a dollar, Michael. He didn't have a machine that you could just tie the refrigerator on, and you could just maybe electronically or with a button have it climb the stairs like you have right now. This man just turned around and went to the refrigerator. Get this now, true story. And he put his back on the refrigerator. And while he had his back on the fridge, they strapped him on. And then this old man, no lie, true story, he bent over and started putting one foot in front of the other and started climbing up the top of the building to deliver the refrigerator. But when I looked at his face, Pastor, he wasn't frowning. He wasn't looking sad. He had a smile on his face because he knew every step I take up these steps, I'm getting closer to my reward. And every step I take is just one more step in my journey to my payday. I've come to tell somebody, step by step, you can stay. Because this is God's purpose, and God will work it out. My time is up. If I had more voice, I know, but I ain't got it, and I don't have it down here. Stand to your feet. Somebody here today, you're going through some stuff. You have a cross that you are. You are now living inside B of your Christian journey. You are no longer simply staring up at the cross. Now you are looking down from it. What are you going to do? Are you going to get off? Are you going to tell God I'm done? Are you going to throw in the towel? Or are you going to look to Jesus and understand that bearing a cross is not just for the super holy, but it's for everybody who bears the name Christian? Bear your cross. Stay on your cross and watch the Lord's purposes work out in your life. I wish I could tell you all every day would be Sunday and you'd never have a hard day in your life. But if God lets you live and die in that ease, you would never understand the nature of your faith. I challenge you. Stay on your cross. Don't quit. Look to Jesus and be encouraged to take one step at a time. Father God,